Hello, Maurice Dimba here. Welcome to our presentation today. Today we are going to talk or fix our side clad panels and do some general reinforcement on the whole structure. If you take a closer look on our gable side, you'll see column supported by beams. I'm talking about these beams connected end to end using end plates. Joint. If you want to check on the joint, double click on the joint, click on the end plate, have a look at the thickness of that end plate. We use the default, but you can feed in your own thickness and press modify. You've actually seen some adjustment. This green cone means that the joint is properly made and in place. Apply and click OK. Go to view, navigate, have a closer look once again. Now we'll go straight to our pilings. Just zoom closer. Start placing our pilings. Go to steel beam. Zoom closer and snap at this end. Take it to that end. There you are. But whatever has come up is not what we require for our clad panels. You change the profile by double clicking on that member. This dialog box of beam properties will come up. Go to profile. Click on select. This dialog box will come up with variety of steel profiles. Now we will be using the C sections. We have variety of C sections here for of UK standard, the BS standard. We'll use this. Click that, apply, modify. There it is. Right click, give it a move command. Snap at the middle, move it at the middle here. Move it the middle there. Right click, go to move command, bring it to the middle there. There we are. Now to populate this along this side, just click, right click, copy, pick it from this end, move it here, same to this end, same to this end. Until you reach to the very last cleat. This is probably our last cleat, but not the very last. Go right to the top of the eave snap it there, right there. Snap it here, right at the corner. Right click to disable that command. Now we'll copy all these to that end. To do that, just click on every member we regarded as Palin. Just click that, click that. But if you're keen enough, you'll be able to see that there's another cleat that we've not fixed our Palin on. Click that, right click, copy, snap at this end, and snap again here at this end. Right click to disable that command. Now we can go on with copying, with selecting all these C sections that we've preferred to be our palins. Just click that, click that, click that. Right click to give it a copy command. Now we'll pick, we'll move all this from this end to this end, because here we opted to put our entry. Put it there. Fix that there. Fix that there. And fix that there. Fix everything the right place. There you are. You're done. Right click to disable that command. We will do the same on the other side. But before you do the same on the other side, you check on your XY axis. It becomes pretty much easier if you are aware on how your axis behave. We'll select all these members again. Select all these. Select everything keenly without including unwanted member. Just click, make sure you click everything. Click that as you go. That and that. That, that and that. That, make sure you click everything. That. Everything have and must be highlighted to be mirrored easily on the other side. We are closer. That and that, that and this. Now we'll go to this side. Right click, special copy, give it a mirror command, and take a look on where you prefer to place your mirror line. Let's zoom closer to pick a point. We pick that point to be our mirror line. bring down here. Click there. Not correct. Okay. There we are. All our palings are fixed on this end. Right click, disable that command, go to isometric view, click that, go to view, navigate with the mouse, all our palings are fixed. You do the same this side. Do that. Go to steel section. Go to steel. Click beam. Pick it from this end. To that end. We want this, the seaside to face inside. Double click on it, click position. We have position on plane, rotation on depth, at depth. On rotation, we have four options. Either click back, not good for us. Front, not good for us. Top, not good for us. Below, exactly what we want. Apply, okay, and give it a move command to sit on top of the cleat. To do that, you have to have a clear visibility. Click on that. Right click. Go to move command. Click at this end. Click at this end. Click, move it that end. Move it again by giving it a move command. Snap at that end. Let's zoom closer and snap it at that end. Not really. There's a clash at this end. Right click, move. Bring it to the middle of the cleat. Click that. Copy everything. To the rest of the cleats. Copy that. Copy that. Just join as you go. Copy that. Copy that. Not right. Delete this. Right click, copy. Pick it from this end. Bring it here. There you are. Go to view, navigate, rotate your model. Now if you take a look, our palings have just extended way out. Just rotate to have a close look. Now what we are going to do, we want to trim off this edge. We'll do this. We'll trim it off by line cut. Down at the command line, it's telling us to pick this end. We'll click the side to remove. We'll click that side. But it has just left us with nothing we want, with something that we don't want actually. Undo that, right click interrupt. Go to view, rotate. Go to edit, like cut by line, click on that. Cut it from there. Cut it from here. And click this end. Undo that. Go to view. Work plane tool. Click there. Place your work plane tool here. And interrupt that. Go to edit, line cut. Click on the profile you want to cut off. You want to cut it off from this end and here. This is the side you don't want. Move around. We actually don't want this.